Welcome to the very important planning, preparation and presentation and the clarification of doubts related to the HSC board exam for the 12th class students. I welcome you all. Let us start with the right with the objectives first. Our main objective is to help and prepare students, to help them to appear confidently for the HSC board examination, which is going to appear. Let me clarify here that this particular presentation is for the fresh students and not for the repeater students. So this point should be very clear that this particular discussion is exclusively for the fresh students and not for the repeater students. One more objective is to provide and facilitate all tips, essentials and prerequisites necessary for the board examination. We have already discussed much about the paper pattern and many videos, and therefore this session is also going to help you to gain enough confidence by identifying areas which need more focus and more importance. Last but not the least, this particular arrangement by the SERT is to bridge the gap between the student and the teacher, to win over the unavoidable crisis which we have been facing for so long. And therefore, this is very important that we need to clarify all our doubts with the help of this session. The present conditions are very clear that where do I stand in these conditions? How much have I understood and what is left out? So how much have you gained till today and what is left out? Exclusively, which areas do I need to focus more and what extra care I need and what type of practice should I do till the board examination or in these remaining days? So we are going to talk at the last of the session what exactly you should do for the remaining 30 days. How can I score more in each subject? This is very clear. Have I made a list of doubts in each subject that can be clarified by any teacher of your own choice? So have you made a list of doubts in English subject? And last but not the least, how should I plan my study in the leftover span? So imagine that you have 30 days remaining for the examination, and how will you go accordingly? Now, this compulsory English textbook is totally new. It has comprehensive competencies. You are learning different things as far as the new textbook is concerned. It is an addition to the literary aspects. So focus is also on the literature, not only on the language. There are new writing skills, syllabus frame to develop English language learning skills for students in order to achieve their future aspirations. So this textbook is going to be a lifelong support for the students of 12th standard. That 25% syllabus that is removed, that is already known to many students, which we are going to repeat in a short while. And we are going to speak something on the oral process and pattern that has changed for this year. And we are going to focus on the details of the oral process also. Now what? Now this particular condition. Now practically succeeding in achieving maximum marks in English is very easy, but it should be a proper methodical and technical type of study, which students should do right from tomorrow, I hope. How should I plan my studies accordingly? What should be your exact plan, your process towards examination? How will I know the exact areas of focus in HSC board examination? So today we are going to discuss on it. What will be my exact direction towards achieving maximum confidence to face the English paper? Maximum confidence. So we need only maximum confidence to score more in English. So this particular session is going to help you in three particular aspects, three basics, that is planning, how you plan your study material, how you plan your study process and techniques, how you prepare for the examination, and how you present the paper on that particular day of the examination. So what we have now, this is nothing but it proves that you are ready for everything that has been done today till today. To prove that you are ready, to prove that you have the potentials, yes, I have this in me and I am certainly going to score more for the examination. So this particular potential is nearly present in everyone. We have to prove our credibility, our inner sense and logical techniques that we have learned till today, and which is certainly going to prove our credibility in our presentation aspects. To prove that you are confident and we are certainly going to present this paper properly, and yes, to prove that you can definitely do it in this way, we are wishing you all the best for this examination. Let us start with the topics which are not in the portion this year. So there are two topics in the prose which are not in the syllabus this year, only for this year. So no questions will be asked on these four topics, two from prose and two from poetry. So these two lessons and two poems are not to be studied this year for the students. Yes, this is the basic theme that you should understand, that prose in overall question paper is asked for 34 marks, poetry for 14, writing skills 16 marks, and 48 marks with options. So there is only one place where you have options, that is writing skills and novel as a genre, where you have 16 marks, and this is particularly related to literature aspect. And so the paper of 80 can be said that it is a paper of 112 marks with options. So this is the basic thing that everybody should know, that this is the general calculation of the assessment of your paper, where you will be assessed in these four areas and accordingly with these marks. Let us start with the prose section, which is the title as reading for comprehension, language study. Language study is divided into three parts, where you have to do as directed, or that is also called as transformation and spot the error. So three parts, then summary writing and mind mapping. So these are the four things that are asked in the first prose section. Paper pattern is already known to you. We are not going to we are not here to tell you the paper pattern, but the aspects of the things which are going to be very, very rigid while assessing your papers, and that we are going to discuss. So question number one is a scene extract from the prose section, where the passage will be asked and you will have to answer these six questions for 12 marks. And therefore, each question carries 2 marks. And when we talk about each and every aspect of question, we have different set of activities which are based on the global understanding, the complex factual, the inference and interpretation analysis type of questions, activities, personal response, language study and vocabulary. So one by one we'll see. So this is the type of question that will appear in the board. By global understanding, we mean that the activities will be based on true and false type questions or activity. It is also called as an activity. Correct the statements, correct the reasons, or write the reasons, complete the following, fill in the blank, sequencing, etc. So such type of global understanding type activities will be asked in the examination. Complex factual is a type of question where the facts are scattered in the extract and you will have to find those facts and collect together and write this answer. So therefore it is called as complex factual and not only factual. So web diagram, flow charts, complete the table, match complete, select proper alternatives, etc. can be asked at this place where you have a complex factual type of question in A2. In A3, you have inference or interpretation type and analysis type question, where you have to draw inference or interpret the ideas which you have understood through the passage. It means that the activities will be based on the deductions type of activities, or guess, or to infer on something, to take out the meaning according to the text and the extract that is asked for the examination. Interpretation also means to interpret, means exactly what you understand or come out to know after reading the text. This question is built on the overall passage. Analysis. So this type of activities are also asked, where we have the same type of activities like web flowchart, complete the table, match complete. And the detailed study from all the angles is necessary to answer this question. In personal response, you have to express your own views, opinions, ideas, similar situations, and the activities will be based on your self-experience, parallel experience, expressing views, your opinions, ideas, whether you agree or disagree, the remedies, measures, solutions, and all sort of such activities where you have to write your own answer for this question and not from the text, not copy from the passage. In language study, you have two activities based for 1 mark. One is do as director and transformation. Let me tell you that no direct questions will be asked from this year. You will have 4 options in grammar for each and every type of grammar activity. So you have to choose your answer from the correct 4 options given under each grammar activity. So this particular pattern has changed for grammar. There is no direct question asked on any grammar question. So this change should be notified, and therefore you have to be prepared for such type of answering such type of activities at the language study area. In vocabulary, you have 2 activities. Maybe you will be asked to find the word register, the meaning of the word, the crossword puzzle, word puzzle or riddle, fill in the blanks, match the pairs. So this is also a activity based type of question. It actually depends on the paper setter whether to directly give the vocabulary type of question or to make it into an activity. So this is the freedom given to the paper setter whether to ask you in that particular way or not. In language study, again, you have B1, B2. B1 is for 3 marks, that is do as directed, transformation of sentence. B2, spot the error. So any error is given in the sentence, whether it is a spelling mistake or it is a grammatical mistake, whether it is a punctuation mark mistake, whether the whole sentence is done topside or V means upside down, or the beginning is the end and then end is the beginning, or you have to find out how the exact sentence will look like and write it accordingly in the answer paper. So spotting the error is very important. So A plus B, 12 plus 4 is 16 marks of section 1, question number 1A and B. Let us move forward. Question number 2 is an unseen passage. I won't discuss it again. So this is all the repetition of the first question 1A, same type of questions, but only the thing is unseen. Unseen passage is never repeated in examinations. It is always a fresh passage. It is always a passage that nobody has ever read it. And therefore, students will have to be prepared for such unseen type of content and write answers for it accordingly. So very good readers of English will certainly find this particular part very easy. For many students, the unseen passage is difficult. For many students, the seen passage also becomes unseen. And for many students, the whole paper is unseen. So that is a part of joke actually. But unseen passage needs certainly very good skills, because a good reading skills, good comprehension skills is certainly going to help the students. In summary writing, you will have to write the summary of the same unseen passage that is given in the question 2A part. And the hints will be given, some points will be given on the basis of which you will have to complete the summary. Now, while writing the summary, it should be a small one paragraph, no making paragraphs in summary, and no writing anything from the, no writing exactly the same from the given original passage. Some words you can take, some theme-based words you can take and write the summary accordingly. So actually, here we have very little time to discuss on what is exactly summary. I think your teachers must have explained you what is summary writing, but remember that it should have a title and your summary should be very, very, very precise. The theme, the central idea of the original passage should be focused in your summary writing. Mind mapping, this is a newly introduced type of skill. It is a creative skill. The question will be like this: develop a mind mapping frame or design using your ideas, thoughts, concepts to illustrate and develop on the given topic. So you have to develop a frame, a design of your own. So no hints, no points will be given to you for mind mapping. Only at the topic will be given. On the based on that topic, you have to complete the whole mind mapping process or the flow of your thoughts and ideas on the paper. So mind mapping is really a fantastic type of creative writing skill introduced for the 12th standard students. So here you can definitely get 3 marks. And why 3 marks? Because these ideas are going to flow from your own mind, your own brain. And if those thoughts and ideas are really logical and fit for that given topic, you are certainly going to get 3 marks. So this confidence can be really achieved if you practice some mind mapping ideas before the examination. So question A, question 2, A, B, C, 12 plus 3 plus 3 is 18 marks. And question 2B, marking scheme is like this. You need not bother for this writing scheme. Just remember it is for 3 marks, because your presentation and your technique and everything is going to matter. But if you know technique, if you want to know technically, this is what it means, that if you are covering all the points in the summary, you are covering language properly, your vocabulary is good, your grammar is good, you are going to get full 3 marks. Same is the case with the mind mapping. There are only 2 things which will be assessed: whether your flow of ideas and concepts and thoughts are very logical for 2 marks, and whether your presentation is done properly for 1 mark. So this 3 marks are covered. Fine. So this is the end of the section 1. Let us move to the section 2 part, which is based on poetry and appreciation. Poetry and appreciation is very important. From that, 2 poems are already removed, so you have only 6 poems, and 1 poem will be asked as a scene extract on which questions activities will be based, and the second poem will be asked for appreciation. So out of 6, 2 poems are sure which you have to. So actually you have no options. You have to study all the 6 poems and see that you give no options to yourself, because any poem can appear in the examination. So don't keep it as an option. So there's a scene extract on the poem for about 10 to 15 lines. The questions are the same type. Only I'm going to discuss about two things, which are nothing but the poetic devices and poetic creativity, which some students may find it little bit difficult. Rest all is the understanding of the whole poem and interpreting it in your words is question A1, A2, A3. Let us talk about A4 and A5 in details. In A4, poetic devices, you can be asked to explain a line or expression from a poem, or you can be asked to explain a novel concept from the poem, which is totally new, something new in the poem, which will be asked to explain. Or they'll ask you to explain the rhyming words or rhyming scheme based on the poem. First stanza, second stanza, third stanza, whatever. Or explain the figure of speech in a poetic line. Or they will give you a figure of speech and ask you to identify the line from the poem, and vice versa. So this is about the poetic devices. Other than this, if anything is asked, it can be a technical aspect, it can be any other element from the poem which can be asked at this area, poetic devices. As far as the poetic creativity is concerned, I think students should focus on this properly, because poetic creativity, these 2 marks are not so easy to achieve. Therefore, I'm giving you some options. You will be asked to compose a small poem of 4 lines on a given topic. Topic will be given, and you will have to compose a poem of your own. So self-composed poem, self-composed. Or some words will be given, and you will be asked to compose 4 lines. Some words will be given. So on the basis of those words, now these words can come at the end of the sentence, it can come at the beginning of the sentence. If they are rhyming, you can keep them at the end of the sentence. So composing a poem based on the given words is also a very challenging task. Then maybe they will give you two lines and they will ask you to complete the remaining two lines in the form of fill in the blanks. Fill in the blanks to compose the poem by using your own ideas, thoughts and imagination. So fill in the blanks is also one type of activity that can be done here. Or complete the given poem by adding two lines of your own to logically compose the poem by yourself. So two lines can be given to you and remaining two lines they can ask you to write. Or last but not the least, compose a small poem of four lines on a topic of your own choice. So topic may not be given and they'll ask you to compose a small poem based on any topic of your own choice, any topic. So these are some of the points which can cover the poetic creativity part. Thank you. So appreciation is, the question will appear in the board examination like this. So read the extract and write as per the instructions. So I think in appreciation, no points, no helping points will be given to the students. No title of the poem will be given. So directly the poem will be given. And so students will have to read the poem and write the appreciation accordingly. So no tips, no points will be given for help to the students and no title will be given to the poem here. So you have to prepare the appreciation accordingly. When I talk about appreciation, let me discuss something about appreciation in details. To appreciate a poem means to complete, means a complete freedom to select the points for appreciation. I like this point, I like this about the poem, I like that about the poem. So it is a complete freedom on in case of the reader to select his or her points for appreciation. So it is not a rigid type of activity that these are the set of points for appreciation and you have to write on these points. So every poem is different. Every poem will definitely have different set of points for appreciation. This is definite. And you cannot measure every poem on the same scale. It's the reader who can decide what to appreciate and what has to be ignored. So it is a total freedom to the reader. And very important, do not look at all the poems with the same angle and with the same perspective. So assessing, evaluating the poem from the reader's point of view is a complete freedom here. Appreciating a poem is a very, very important aspect where the aesthetic sense is measured through your appreciation. So speaking something good about something good that is already done in front of you needs a basic preparation. It needs a basic technique and you need to be very good at language when you appreciate. Okay. The scheme of marking for appreciation is like this. The appropriateness of theme and language, 2 marks, explanation and presentation, 1 mark, personal opinion and evaluation, 1 mark. Writing skills are very important aspects in the form of preparation for the whole year, which needs too much time to prepare and present. So basically, preparation and presentation part is very important in writing skills. If I ask you the question, which are the writing skills for the 12th class, I think I'll get the answer in this way. We have summary, writing, mind mapping, appreciation. These are also writing skills, but the writing skills that are asked at the fourth section are all this. So these are the different writing skills asked. So there are 12 writing skills in the fourth section. Apart from these three, and these three I have put in bold and dark and in red color because these are totally new for the 12th class and these all are you have studied in the 11th. So this can be a repetition this year, but the challenge is to score maximum in the section. So let us go one by one. So the question in the board will appear like this. So A set has three drafting virtual messages, statement of purpose and group discussion here. Now, out of these three, student will have to choose any one and write any one. Now, same is the case with all the other B, C, D sets. So, too much of choice, too much of options is here. Out of this three, email, report, interview, student will write any one by his own choice. Speech, comparing and expansion of ideas, here you have only one to write. Students will make their own choice here also, and even in the last one, review, blog and appeal. So this is a very good package for the students to score maximum and get maximum out of 16 marks in this particular question 4th, A, B, C, D. Very important. Actually, here we have very little time to speak on each and every writing skill individually. If you have any doubts, we can explain those later in the remaining part. Fine. So each is for 4 marks, and this question is very important from all the angles. So this is a marking scheme for drafting virtual messages or statement of purpose or group discussion. The same, the flow is same, like 2-1-1, 2-1-1, 2-1-1. But the assessment will be done in these areas. Please go through. This is the case of email. Then or you have report or your interview. Let me talk about interview. I can focus more on this. In interview, a specific format is given to you. You will have to write in that proper format. And when you write the questions, the areas of making your questions or drafting your questions, preparing your questions are given on the left hand side. So based on those areas only, you will have to prepare the questions and not on any other area, because we just seen that students just they mug up 8 questions and they write in the examination. So it was better to take this move and make students write on a particular area in the interview process for that honorable distinguished personality. In the C part, we have these three: speech, comparing and expansion of ideas, where the same marking scheme is there, but the assessment areas are different. I think you need not pay attention to this, because the writing process is more important. The review, blog and appeal. So this presentation is going to remain on YouTube, so you can review it whenever you want. This is question 4D. Now it is said that, let me come to the main question again. In some writing skills, the word limit is given 100 to 150 words. That doesn't mean that you should count or the paper assessor will count the words. So this word limit is given in order to make clear that the writing skill should not be very small and it should not be very big. I think one writing skill should end on one page of the answer paper, where you have questions like email, you have questions like blog, where you have to stay fixed to the format, and you cannot exceed the word limits and 100 and 150 words. So need not worry about the given word limit in the questions. You stick to the format, stick to the length, how much to write, how to write and how much to write, what to include, what sort of vocabulary is to be used in the writing skills. So all this preparation is very necessary for preparing each and every writing skills in and present it in that particular order. So again, let us move forward. So let me tell you that you have to keep practicing writing skills. And let me give you some basic skills. You have to solve multiple examples to gain confidence. You have to collect good vocabulary for each and every writing skill, some quotes, phrases for good presentation. You have to understand the proper format and structures for each You have to know exactly the process of beginning and how to end. So some students never know where their writing skill starts and where it ends. So you have to know it at first, because this is a pre-learned or pre-understood type of skill that you know that you are going to present it in the examination. Three and very basic questions: what to write, how to write, and how much to write. If these three questions are understood properly, you will never face any problem in presenting any writing skill in the question paper. Last section, question number 5A. In 5A, you have activities on history of English novel. So this particular section is based on the literary genre, that is novel, and it is also for 16 marks. So activities, only this is the only place in question 5A where you have activities, because the pattern has changed and the activities will be based on framed MCQs, that is multiple choice questions. Match the columns, chronological order, fill in the blanks, true or false, elements of the novel. And this is a very good explanation done in the textbook. So you prefer the textbook for this particular question 5A preparation, and it will give you 100% all the type of answers based on any type of questions asked. Let me also tell you that this is only the place where it is activity based. So activities are asked on the English novel for two marks. But B, C, D, so question 5B, question 5C and question 5D are totally different, and the novelty has been bought in the question paper. So 4.1 from the textbook is going to clarify all your doubts in the English novel, history of English novel. So questions, activities based on history of English novel will be asked from 4.1 of your textbook. Moving forward, question 5B. Now here, direct questions, or these are called as memory based questions. Memory means you have to understand the novel. If you have read it properly, you have to remember, then you have to interpret your ideas about that particular situation, maybe character or sequence of the novel, a particular scene. It can be whether about any plot structure, theme, setting, or language or character. So direct questions are asked here. So you'll ask to describe something, you'll be asked to explain something or compare something, contrast, name, discuss, any type of question, direct question will be asked. So describe a character in such and such novel. So in 4.2, so this type of B part is going to be set on 4.2 of your textbook. So in the B part, all the questions will appear from the 4.2 section, 4.2, section 4, 4.2. In the second part, you will be asked in details, more details, that is illustrate something, interpret something, narrate something, justify, find something, identify, or any other particular type of question which is in the mind of the paper setter can be asked here. And the same is the case with C and D. Only this part changes, that is 4.3 and 4.4. So we have four different things in the fourth section. In the C, it is same. Here it is based on 4.3 C part. And in the D part, it is the same. Now let me tell you, students, that the reading of the complete novel, maybe in the textbook you are reading a part, maybe just some selected part of the original novel. It is preferable for each and every student to get the original copy of the novel and read it, so that you understand the character, the scenes, the elements, the setting, the language, and therefore interpretation of all these things will be very easy if you read the original novel. So see that still you have time and keep reading English novels. Fine, this was the end of the question paper, where important things such as summary writing, appreciation type question, where new things like SOP, drafting virtual messages, and group discussions are added to the question 4 in writing skills. And also this memory based questions are something new for you, and so that you need to be a very good reader. Previously the highest in English was more about 92, 93, 94, 95, 96. So this particular paper format may not give the students so many marks. So it is really challenging type of question paper. And being a little practical one, little literature oriented one, you need to practice, you need to read, because you cannot take English very lightly this time, at least for the new structure, new paper pattern. So seriousness has to be maintained in the incoming 30 days. Let me tell you something about the oral examination, which is for 20 marks, where the objective of the oral process the process should be understood properly. What to do before the exam and what to do during the examination. Before and during is very important. So we have just two skills, listening skill and speaking skills for the oral examination, and which is for 10 marks each. So both the preparation and presentation should be understood. The process, this exam is for 20 marks, divided into two parts, the listening part and the speaking part, both are for 10 marks each, which I have already told you. Listening skill will be taken on the answer sheet provided by the board. And the speaking skill is an individual test. It is an individual test where the student will be called for an interview based type communication, one-to-one face-to-face communication, and some questions will be asked. So let me tell you about something about listening and speaking skills in details. This 10 marks, the examiner has two options among the three given below to test the listening skill of the students. So actually there are three options, but examiner will use only two options. Which are these two options? The three options are like this. The teacher may read a slightly longer sentence and ask you to write something about the sentence, or ask you to write the whole sentence. In the second part, teacher will read a short poem in the class and ask you to write something about the poem in 4 to 5 lines. In the same case with the story, teacher will read a short story, and teacher will ask you to write something about the short story in 6 to 7 lines. So the teacher in the class for the oral examination can ask you any two activities in this particular part for 5 plus 5 marks. So any two from this. So any two options will be used from the above. So what should the student do? Listening to a slightly longer sentence, the teacher will read the slightly longer sentence twice. You will listen to it very carefully and with full concentration. You will have to write it on the answer sheet provided by the board. So this is something about the slightly longer sentence. In listening to a slightly longer sentence, you will be tested in these three. Your ability to focus, maybe whether you have written all the details, whether you are accurate in either listening to marks. So in this way, you will get these 5 marks. In the second part, speaking part. Speaking is a short interview where the student will be called by the teacher and you'll have face-to-face communication. Now teacher will ask the student to speak on one or more topics. For example, teacher can ask the student to introduce, self-introduction, share an experience, any description about anything, a memorable incident, your career plans, what are your career plans, what are your ambitions in life, your dream in life. Or such type of question regarding recent accomplishment, any award that the student has received, or any reward, or any other topic that the examiner may ask the student of his own choice to speak on his own choice, any topic. So I have given this example, that doesn't mean these are only the examples. There are n number of examples, there are hundreds and thousands of examples where the teacher can ask anything to the student to speak on, depending on the background of the college, the background of the student, the background of the that institution, the background of the whole scenario at the college, that particular question can be asked at that particular level. Speaking skill of a student will ultimately test his skill in comprehension, understanding of the topic for 2 marks, preparation and confidence level 2 marks, body language, tone, vocabulary, grammar 2 marks, content, novelty, fluency 2 marks, and overall communication 2 marks. So these speaking skill is for 10 marks and the overall speaking of the student is going to be tested in these areas. So kindly note. So you can ultimately create wonders in 30 days which are remaining for your examination. Why 30? Because if there are 35, 34, I will not calculate those 4 to 5 days or maybe 10 days more. So let us in general calculate how we can create wonders in 30 days. So your 1 hour study, which is associated, we are taking for granted there, you are going to study for 1 hour. What you should do in that particular 1 hour every day, right from tomorrow. For example, you will have to choose one scene passage from section 1 with all its activities, reading the passage, finding its vocabulary, meanings and its activities, all for 20 marks. So one passage every day, along with one passage, one extract from the poem with its activities for 15 minutes. Or if you have finished poems, you can go for the section 4 topic and select any one from that and complete all its activities for 15 minutes. So this is your choice. So 20, 15 minutes, then 10 minutes, you have to study 10 sentences of language study, sentences, grammar sentences. Each day, 10 sentences are enough. But study them in such a way that you will never face any problem in those areas. One writing skill every day for 15 minutes. So in this way, 20, 15, 10 and 15. So 30 plus 30, you have 60 minutes. I mean, this is the calculation. This is my plan. This is my plan. If I would be the student, I would plan like this. Your plan can be something different, or you can have your own plan to deal with English in the similar way. Your plan can be something different. So 1 hour study should be associated with all these areas from the question paper. You have to touch every area of the question paper every day so that your question paper, your activity sheet in the examination will be found very easy by the student, and maybe that day he will think that I am not doing anything different rather than the usual regular study. So please create wonders in 30 days. So this is our basic plan for you all. Wishing you all the very best for the incoming HSC examination and thanking you very much. Thank you.